Now, before we go to question answer, we can have two, three questions, no? One or two questions. I'll just take 1 minute before we switch over to that. You know, this National Solar Energy Federation is a national platform that we have created for, you know, incorporating all these kind of suggestions and addressing issues of national importance for solar energy. Recently, we gave a big memorandum of about 10 points which are of nationally important. So I have been carefully avoiding saying this for the past 5 years, but today I can very confidently say that we are an apex national solar association which is consulted by the government. We are in a big way being involved in the reinvest planning, also the COP23 that is going to take place, climate change talks with the government. So friends who are not members, I suggest you should all become members. The forms, etc., are available across, and we join this national movement where we influence and interact with the government to see that the right kind of policies are there. We are essentially policy advocacy people. Anyway, having said that, yes, Mr. Sikri, you can have the question, and I'm very happy that Mr. Sikri is here. Generally corporate bodies, but we are also considering creating think tanks separately. But still, as on date, it is only for corporate bodies. Yeah, Mr. Sikri.
Thank you. Myself, R.K. Sikri. बहुत अच्छी प्रेजेंटेशन, बहुत अच्छी नॉलेजेबल एंड विजनरी आप लोगों ने कही है एक्चुअली. बट हम ये जानना चाहते थे कि आज की जो हमारी ये स्केल की महफिल है, ये फाइनेंस एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट के ऊपर थी एक्चुअली. पर हम सब ने सिर्फ टेक्निकल की बातें की, फ्यूचर की बातें भी की, स्टोरेज की बात की, सेंसिटिविटी एनालिसिस बहुत अच्छी की, पर किसी ने फाइनेंस एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट के बारे में बात नहीं की कि रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी पे एनपीए क्यों बढ़ रहा है. सेकंड मेरा ये पॉइंट था, एनपीए रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी के सेक्टर में एनपीए बढ़ रहा है, बैंक वाले लोन नहीं देना चाहते, इवन एरेडा एंड पीएफसी भी रिलक्टेंट होती हैं लोन, क्योंकि मैं समझता था कि आज का जो टॉपिक था वो फाइनेंस एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट से लिंक था, पर हम सब ने टेक्निकल और सिर्फ सोलर की बात की. जब तक क्लीन टेक्नोलॉजी की बात है, उसमें बहुत सारे फैक्टर और भी हैं सोलर के अलावा, पर क्या हम लोग सोलर से ही गवर्न कर रहे हैं हर चीज़ को? मेरा सेकंड क्वेश्चन ये था जो तानिया मैडम के लिए था. बहुत अच्छी इन्होंने प्रेजेंटेशन दी सेंसिटिविटी एनालिसिस के ऊपर, और जहाँ तक मैं समझता हूँ कि ये सेंसिटिविटी एनालिसिस 15-20 साल पहले भी थी, आज भी है. यंग लड़कों के लिए हो सकती है ये एक इन्फॉर्मेटिव, बट मैं आपका एक्सपीरियंस ये जानना चाह रहा था कि इतना नॉलेज होने के बाद पूछूं, कोई भी डेवलपर मेगावाट आवर के बेस पे प्लांट क्यों नहीं लगाता है एक्चुअली? अब जितने भी प्लांट देखो सोलर के लगे हैं, चाहे इवन विंड के भी जो बात कर रहे हैं तो लगे हैं, वो सिर्फ इन्वेस्टमेंट पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से और रिटर्न ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट के पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से ही लगे हैं. किसी ने आज तक ये नहीं देखा कि उसमें जो आपने प्रेजेंटेशन में कहा कि मेगावाट आवर के बेस में, आपका क्या एक्सपीरियंस है, इतना छोटा सा क्या एक्सपीरियंस है, क्यों नहीं लगाते हम लोग मेगावाट आवर के प्लांट?
थैंक यू फॉर आस्किंग कंपोजिट 3-4 क्वेश्चंस. नंबर वन, दैट फाइनेंस हैज बीन कवर्ड. इट विल नॉट बी करेक्ट टू से दैट फाइनेंस हैज नॉट बीन कवर्ड. तानिया हैज कवर्ड इट वेरी वेल, देयर इज एब्सोल्युटली नो डाउट ऑन दैट. एंड आई ऑल्सो सेड दिस माई पोस्टुलेट दैट इनफ फंड्स आर अवेलेबल फॉर अ गुड प्रोजेक्ट. नाउ as far as NPA is concerned, I do not think that fundamental assumption is not correct. You may quote one or two examples here and there, otherwise people are flourishing. You will not believe, anybody who becomes my member, generally people don't have this priority. Their priority is profit, their own projects, etc. Only I am the last priority, then people give money. And by just going by that standard, people and you know, the number of membership that is increasing. And you know, it is absolutely to be understood that even manufacturers, it is their order books are full. whatever you say, at least I have members, so I can very confidently say that. आप NPA की बात कर रहे हैं, but NPA का there may be one or two sporadic examples. I don't think anybody from the panel will say that there are NPAs.
I will just cover. See, because I am discussing when the global investors. So if you compare, so it is not the technology, even it is not the radiation or wind resources, it is not the O&M. In India, basically the biggest challenge is the regulatory. What I covered, I told you, the transmission distribution charges. Like what is the, you just fix the formula and on that basis you create extrapolation one can create. So basically no regulatory issues are more. Like in wind you are saying FIT model, then in Maharashtra and many state people have put the plant.
You answered.
There's no PPA.
You answered.
So those type of issues are there. Like Andhra, when people have finished the project in March, people, government is saying, I will not give you the GBI, I will not give you the this, you come for renegotiation. So these type of issues are there.
Okay. I think we are running short of time.
So yeah. Financial, what I say.
Sure, thank you. And now we can have offline discussions, unless Tanya, yes, you should.
I think solar and renewable as a larger thing has moved against just say it's no longer just CSR. All of us sitting here are because we believe that this sector can create money for us, our investors, and it has a commercial relevance. Okay, we are here to stay. So, which is why making money for the debt guys, equity guys, all becomes critical. And thus the megawatt hour becomes important. What you hear is the first part of the story that are there returns, but the returns comes by making the megawatt hour. Yes, we started it as a CSR responsibility to say we should have green power, but the value proposition of solar and wind has now got embedded in the model that it is the payment security is in there. You are here to stay. It is no longer just CSR. You are here to make money in it. It is a business.
Thank you very much. Like we are almost towards the end of the calendar year 2017, and I believe it has been one of the most eventful years in the history of energy sector. Solar prices we've seen dropping from the levels of 4.63, 4.34 to 3.3, and probably that was not enough to make the government happy. And then we saw 2.65, 2.45. Then the surprise came of wind dropping to all-time low. So headways and good growth path for solar sector. The module prices that everybody was expecting, since the FIT was going to expire in the end of June or July in China, and there was a new scheme for households, and FIT went up despite the new precedent in US. The global corporations were expecting that panel prices will go down, the demand will go down. It has not been the case. Like the industry in US getting stronger every day. So quite an eventful year. Now we have a different set of challenges, I believe. We're talking, there's buzz around power surplus, or though power surplus is not very correctly defined, we need a lot of distribution reforms so that we can have the last mile connectivity, and then we can assess if we're really power surplus or not. And right now, a lot of developers have been struggling to get the panels cleared from customs, PPA renegotiation, such kind of things has been there. And I'm sure at RE Invest and you know, times to come, all these challenges will be solved. And definitely one point I would like to make in the support of distributed solar, all the advanced economies or the pioneers in the solar sector, like Germany and all, the proportion of rooftop or distributed solar has been much bigger in the overall solar energy mix. So has not been the case in India till now. And now with this current power dynamics of power surplus and henceforth the power tariffs going up, distributed solar is going to probably hit in a big way in this country. So with this, I thank all the speakers for the inaugural session. It is our great pleasure. We are deeply honored and enlightened. Thank you very much on behalf of the entire conference attendees, all the partners. Thank you very much. A big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, for this wonderful session. I'd like to take this opportunity to request our session chair Pranav Mehta ji to present a small token of appreciation and memento to all the speakers on the dais, please.
Before we end, I think we should greatly congratulate EQ for consistently organizing these finance events and also other events across the country. So that consistency part is very important. So really, Anand and his team,
Thank you, sir. Deserve
a lot of applause. And when Rajnish Khattar claps, you have to see that it is much more than clapping, because he knows how this can be done, how difficult it is to do all this. So I am very happy that Anand, all the best wishes.
Thank you very much, sir. So glad for your blessings. Thank you very much.